So big change up there.
Well, that means that Earthshaker or that Omni Knight is indeed a core, and it's
looks like it's an Omni Knight core.
Omni Knight core.
As Giannis was saying.
Yeah.
No, I'm just kidding.
Do you want to say I told you so, or no. Just do it little dance?
It was definitely just it was a flexible thing. They could have changed it up for sure.
Did we see him pick it yet?
No, we didn't see him pick
could
it.
Could be Earthshaker. It used to be an offer.
No, GH picked Earthshaker already.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Well, screw you then.
Guys, you need to make a decision. Imperial or Liquid?
I think Liquid for the sole reason that they can... I think they scale slightly better into the late game.
I have to agree. They have Bloodlust, they have Lifestealer, they have most of their key heroes, and if they pull through laning phase, it's kind of like the same thing. Omni Knight's extremely strong in this team fighting potential.
I've seen Weaver, Abaddon do great before for Imperial, and I believe they can do it again. We're going to find out who is right and who is wrong. We're going to also find out what our commentators have to say about this first game versus with Imperial versus Team Liquid. Let's go OD Pixel and Gods.
Prepare for battle!
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Aces RG Dream League. I'm Odie Pixel, I'm here with Cods. We're ready to take you through the second series of the day. Game 1 is Liquid versus Imperial. The game started, let's kick ourselves into it, and it should be a fun one. We've got something a little bit different coming out from both sides. Liquid, I think a lot of people are going to have eyes on them, see how GH continues to play. Obviously, yesterday we saw him with two great performances. They were on the Ruby, he's going to be on the Shaker this time around. We're seeing Mind Control on a core Omni Knight. A lot of crazy stuff going on. What are you looking forward to?
I mean, there are probably some Liquid fans maybe curious to see how GH does, but there's probably a lot more curious to see Miracle play some Shadowfiend.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. Miracle SF. I mean, there's your 9k MMR player on Shadowfiend. Matu Lifesteal. I mean, that's not something you necessarily look forward to playing, but you know it's his best hero, and that's when the pricks came out. I was like, it's pretty hard to kind of go against the Matu Lifestealer. It's just been so good. It's been the one hero that Matu has just been dominant on, that Liquid just seemed to always win with. I do like Imperial's draft for the OD. I think OD this game is incredibly strong. You're looking at four melee heroes on the Liquid side. The repel on the SF could be a bit of a problem, so finding into the magic menu. Ace, bottom rune. He's stolen the bounty rune. All right. Grand Theft Bounty rune.
Easy room for Weaver.
Okay. But yeah, looking at the Imperial draft, it's very much to me a draft around the OD being a powerful monster. The Weaver probably going to have to build into the Diffuser to help deal with the repel. But OD Weaver, two ranged cores, as well as a Batrider BKB piercing disable against melee heroes, against an SF and Omni Knight. Like, I want to say, like, I actually quite like Imperial's draft this game. I almost prefer it.
Do you like these lanes? So look what Imperial put in Hester Joe mid against the SF. Is this the plan? This is just a matchup that SF has a really hard time in?
It's a tougher matchup than the OD, I guess. But Ogre's going to rotate in. I think they also look at it like OD with the dual lane. Like, whoever you send mid is going to have a rough time against the potential Ogre harass. So they'd rather the bat not free farm. But yeah, it's a curious little lane. And top lane, OD's going to free farm. They know this is the lane where they get uncontested free farm. Weaver's actually a really strong kind of off lane farming core with a bit of support. So Imperial want to try and win two out of the three lanes, and it's really bottom and top they're trying to win. They're not really putting back mid. Oh, Kuro. Yeah, can he time it? He can't.
Wow, with seven stacks of napalm on him.
Oh, that's such a good start for Hester Joe.
Oh, I know.
Mid is the one lane Imperial aren't trying to win. They're not sending Bat there because he counters the SF. Yeah, Bat 1v1 does quite well against SF, but they know the Ogre's going to be there. They're trying to win bottom and top. Shut down Matu's Lifestealer with this dual lane, and of course, free farm the Baby Knight OD.
Yeah, really nice little play from Hester Joe. Just kind of punishing what we've seen Ogre Magi's do in every single game. Throw out harassment, deny themselves to Ancients. Hester Joe is not going to let you get away with that.
Yeah. So early on, kind of even CS looking at some of the key lanes here with Hester Joe. Perhaps obviously zero CS on a mid bat, right? It doesn't look good, but bat pretty terrible at last hitting. And SF already with 14 souls, giving him 28 bonus damage. Definitely, probably the lane we don't expect Imperial to do well. If anything, they may see Hester Joe caught out. Not Miracle, not going for the long race. He just wants this one wave of creeps, and he'll probably fall back because this is looking like rough times. He's actually being chased by a hasted Shaker.
Oh, that's scary.
He should live. He's got Tranquils. He might actually win this fight.
Okay, well, GH.
Yep, GH. Meaning remove the god part of your name there, mate.
He had a couple of good games yesterday. It really is a show to see if he's a one-hit wonder on the Rubik.
Hashtag bring back Bulba.
Bring back Bulba. Oh, dear. But he went for the play. Yeah, he could quite make it happen.
Yeah, that having Tranquil is perhaps a bit of a surprise for him. Maybe he didn't check the items there. Ace at bottom getting gone on between Chikuchis and nice initiation from Liquid. They found an opening where Chikuchi wasn't up. He'd used it aggressively and they kill him off.
Oh, and they'll see if they can maybe just get a bit of damage onto Noia there. They're not going to be able to finish him off. Yep. But that is scary. You know, giving kills to Matuma Man. We saw what I believe it was in the series the other day against Ad Finnum. He was getting kills. He was killing the offlaner. And then suddenly he wins the game. You've got to be careful about giving Matuma Man a good start on Lifestealer.
Absolutely. They haven't really shut... he's 11 CS, which is not... His CS isn't great, but he's getting kills.
It's scary.
It's enough CS to get by. Like, you're not expecting him to win the to free farm against this Weaver Abaddon lane, but he's out farming the Weaver. The hero that's quote-unquote countering him is having a rough laning stage. So if anything, Imperial putting their carry player Ace in the offlane and losing the CS battle there is a big concern. They're not sending Weaver bottom to slow down Lifestealer's farm. They're expecting him to beat the Lifestealer in farm, which has not happened. Your mind control is even bullying Baby Knight here. What is going on? Potential lift is there and doesn't look like they'll go for it.
And Baby Knight to salve up. I mean, obviously, receiving harassment, but CSing fine in this top lane as expected. 24-13 down bottom. Kuroki being chased down. GH is there to help him out. He's going to guard up the Arcane Rune. He'll have to take it, though. He's worried about Ace grabbing it. And now Ace just turning his attention towards GH. And indeed, they could go for a bit of the chase down. Ace coming in with a final Shikuchi. Couple of touches. Fisher isn't going to be allowed to get out. Cast animation too long. And Imperial getting the kill on Earthshaker yet again. So GH already falling twice this game.
Yeah, that's not too big a deal as far as Shaker dying. I think if you're Liquid, you're just looking more at where you can contribute, finding those kills, securing Matu a good start. You're pretty happy with just how things have kind of got going for you, even with GH giving up the couple of kills. Mind Control's getting experience and even a few CS here and there in the offlane. So all in all, decent start for Liquid. SF, of course, free farming away, crushing the CS against the Batrider. I mean, Bat had more kills than he had CS for a while there, so not what you want to see on your mid, but Bat's going in for a kill. Yeah, TP out from Miracle. It's going to be close.
Oh,
he's actually dead.
Oh, goodness! Oh, miscalculation there from Miracle.
Not expecting the flame break, but you really have to respect the potential flame break. We're seeing this more and more. I mean, S4 used to do this all the time when he played mid Batrider for Alliance. He'd go for that cheeky little early point in flame break, and suddenly you find a kill at, like, level 5 with it, and that's exactly what Hesterjo just did. This guy, he's definitely one of those stand-up... As far as, like, stand-up players on this team, I think he is, like, the... He's the kind of player that stands out to me individually a lot of the time.
Bottom lane making a go on to Noia. He'll try and deny himself with a missed call. It's not going to happen. And it's worrying. Matuma Man killing spree before the 6-minute mark.
And now he's free farming. He actually has 30 CS, so he's getting the farm now. He started slow, but he's... Since getting a couple of kills, he's just been free farming away.
Yeah, we'll see what Hesterjo can kind of pull out for the team with this momentum that he's got in the mid lane, just as we saw, just 1v1ing, taking
solo
down.
Solo killed Miracle, despite Miracle having a, like, 30 CS lead.
And now he might get himself involved in something else. He's looking for Kuroki. He does have a lasso available. He's just going to do this.
Oh, he's going for Miracle instead.
And indeed he is. He's got the Firefly down, dragging him up. Right. He's got a Fade Bolt in a second. Hesterjo kiting them up. There's the Fade Bolt. He's going to tick down one in the Firefly. 3 stacks on Miracle. Hesterjo coming back in. Could he actually pull it off here? No. He will go down. Can't finish off Miracle. Yeah. Miracle getting the double kill. Not the play that Imperial wanted to give.
No, not what they were looking for here. Yep. He turned around. He could have just gone. They could have killed the Ogre with no casualties, but he said, let's go big or go home. Went for Miracle. Didn't pay off. He landed all the raises he needed to, especially that long raise was not the easy one to land. It didn't get any, like, killing damage onto him, but it got the Batrider to that low threshold where by the time he went back in, it was low enough that they could finish off that kill. Curious to see if he's not picking up any kind of, like, raindrops. He wants to get probably just the fastest blink possible, but having, like, a raindrops if you're going for those aggressive plays against an SF definitely can help. But it's kind of at that point where damage has been done. Miracle is now farmed. He's got 3.5k gold. He's farming neutral stacks. You're not really going to be able to shut him down. You've just got to accept that you're going to be versing a farmed SF come mid-game.
Now, Ryze coming back towards mid as well. I mean, obviously with the telekinesis and the lasso, we see that they can come close to bringing him down. Meanwhile, up top, mind control. Not finding the farm necessarily, but he is getting the levels on this Omni Knight. Yeah.
I think you look at this top lane, like, you've kind of gone maybe slightly better than you'd hoped if you're Liquid. Yeah, it's OD. OD is going to free farm. That's completely impossible to stop, but you still look at the net worth, and it's not like OD's storming ahead. He's not going any kind of minus. He's not a hero that can rotate and farm the jungle as well as the lane. OD only farms the lane. So they've given the OD free CSing rain, but they managed to out-farm him through getting kills on lifesteal and jungle farm on SF.
Make it a go onto Estijo, who get the last off, trying to get himself away from Kurogi. The fish is there for GH. Snipes the bat very nicely.
I mean, GH, despite the misplays where he got too aggressive at mid and then his second death may be avoidable as well, he's hit some good... he's been in the right place at the right time, and he hit some good fissure blocks at bottom. So definitely some good movement coming out from the Shaker. Bottom lane, they're looking for Matu. He's getting kind of low, may need an infest out.
He should be alright with the infest. He's just more wants to maybe try and make something happen with this. Looking for Noya. He'll turn towards Ace, realizing actually Ace is very low on mana. Yeah. And with a Fissure, Ace, can he get himself out of this one? And the shield will help. It looks like it will be enough to get him back. But a bit of a close situation there.
Couldn't quite get to the Abaddon. If he got the open wounds on him, it's a kill. But Weaver, without mana, became a good target as well. But Abaddon able to shield and heal him back to at least a healthy enough state to survive that. This is great stuff for Liquid. The Omni Knight, again, it's this here in the offlane where you're not really caring about his farm too much. He's getting the levels he needs to still just throw a Repel in the SF later on. Throw a Purification onto a Lifestealer in the front lines to get some extra damage output. All in all, this is a dream Liquid start.
Ace, again, toying around with Matsuma Matt. He's pretty hard for them to catch out, you know, he's got the time-lapse available. Yeah. I guess, with this build on the Earthshaker, putting the extra points into the Aftershock, I guess that's so you've got the chain stun potential between the Fissure, getting him with the Enchant, having that passive lockdown.
Yeah, the level 1 Fissure's fairly value as far... I mean, the stun duration, it doesn't scale that amazingly well on Earthshaker. The damage is also not... Like, Fissure scales okay. It's not great, and it also costs more mana as you level up, so if anything, you're getting off more Fissures by keeping it level 1. And then, as you said, the totem stun becomes more reliable with the more points in Aftershock. It's always kind of a toss-up. Most Earthshakers will max the Fissures, so by no means is this a standard build.
Up top, mind control, playing around with Rising Estijo, as we're seeing with the Repel up and a couple of points in the DGN Auries. There's not really a lot that they can do about this Omni. He kind of has free roam walking around the map. It just takes too many resources, really, to try and kill him at this stage. Yeah. If you're Imperial, you're much better looking elsewhere. Ryze gets a nice deal, though. He has got that level 4 Purification.
Very nice, I'd say, as far as if Imperial are looking to fight right now, having a Purification helps him a lot. But here come Liquid looking to take it off his hands. Does seem something that Ryze is maybe aware of as he pulls the lane back to help protect himself. Yeah, this doesn't seem like the start Imperial were hoping for. Estijo TP's in immediately. This is actually not too bad for him. He's pretty tanky and can't easily be killed. It's the SF they have to be scared of, though.
They've also got Noya here as well. They're sending in a 4th TP to get telekinesis on one. Miracle's going to be grabbed. Lasso back. GH God with the Fissure to hold Imperial away from Miracle. Miracle be allowed to escape it now. Matsuma Man turning up. They may even try and turn and fight. Matsuma Man held back by Baby Knight's Astral.
Yeah, Baby Knight's TP'd in, but has no mana, so not ideal for him.
Kuroki going for the TP out. He will make it.
Big, it was like a 5v5. I say 5v5, there wasn't much fighting happening, but both teams bringing their entire lineup to the mid lane, recognizing that this is like that key fight where if you lose it badly, it could turn into a tower, and whoever wins it could snowball, so they just make sure they bring numbers. Like, as soon as you see that OD TPing from top to mid, you know Imperial mean business. Like, they're looking to really take the fight, and that's where Matu's like, okay, I'll come, make sure we even it up. Matu gets seen, Imperial see Matu, and they're like, okay, we can't actually fight this lifestealer.
GH just finding a little bit from this bottom lane now, but it's got to be a bit careful. They've got three down there at the moment on the side of Imperial. Meanwhile, though, mid lane, the remainders of that kind of 5v5 attempt sticking mid on the side of Liquid as they're pushing onto the tier 1, and they've also got Matsuma Man hiding inside the Hellbear Smasher behind the tower.
Gives them free reign to just go scouting and not worrying about it. Normally, if you're a lifestealer and you're on the front lines, you get Blink Lasso and you could get blown up during the chain stun. There's a lasso into telekinesis, so being in a creep like this just gives you that little bit of extra freedom to go behind the tower to scout, even potentially initiate for your team. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Oh, he could make something nice happen now, because Miracle, he's got the Shadow Blade on the way out, and he's also got a double damage rune bottled up.
Yeah, that's nice. Very problematic. He's actually going to TP top, looking to set up on kill on Ace, and he's got level 2
here
ultimate.
He's going for it.
Oh boy, this is...
I mean, he could really
like
catch it off guard. We'll see how
looks
Ace
like
reacts.
Looks like a dead Weaver.
Here we go! Don't you gotta move! Bam!
He's
oh
here.
Yeah! Easy one for Miracle. Ace was, I don't think he knows what hit him. He just disappeared.
Nope. Nothing wrong with Ace's play there. You see four heroes bottom, you're thinking, alright, four heroes bottom. It's my job to push out top and pressure the lane to force TP's back, but little do you know, Miracle's picked up a Shadow Blade and can solo kill him.
Maybe not, actually.
Not done.
With the Astral holding him back, and it's a good job as well, because GH was about to Fissure block him up.
Yeah. One Fissure could be... Miracle!
He has to catch the TP. Smart little play there from Baby Knight. Doesn't risk it. Gets himself off the TP and holds him back. Yeah.
Pretty sure that was enough time to get another right click off and kill him there.
Oh, absolutely.
So, good call from Baby Knight, being well aware of the situation. Gets himself out, but still 7.5k net worth SF you got to deal with now. See what he goes into. He's picked up an Ogre Club. Could be the BKB, but you've got Repel on your side. Something you can't always rely on against Diffusal Blade. But if you look at this Weaver's farm, he's not picking up a Diffusal anytime soon. If anything, maybe we see like a Dragonlance type pickup on Miracle just to help them siege. He's got Bloodlust, so he's got the attack speed as well as the Repel. Having a cost-effective Dragonlance seems like a reasonable pickup to me, but BKB also seems fine. Between BKB and Repel, he'll just have constant magic immunity, which means OD's doing no damage to him, Bat's doing no damage to him, and Weaver's doing very little damage to him.
Yeah, absolutely. With the Ring of Health and Blightstone at the moment, not a lot going for the Weaver in terms of damage output. Ace still needing a bit more time before he becomes the threat that he wishes to be. Mid lane, bit of a jump in. Got the Astral from Baby Knight, but immediately Mitsuma Man, he's turned up, he's ready to turn. They're moving in onto Baby Knight. The Aphotic Shield from Noya helping him to back up. Mitsuma Man, not to be questioning how hard he wants to commit to this one. And indeed, it looks like the decision will be made for him by Baby Knight as he's held back.
Yep. It wasn't a Fissure available there to really easily chase with. It was on cooldown still, so... No play coming out, but... Yeah, it will be a Dragonlance for Miracle. He's got the Elven Skin banned as well now. So, I think Liquid looking at this game, like... It's been a pretty kind of, I say, slow pace. Like, both teams are making their plays and movement. We haven't seen, like, the big five-man smokes yet. We haven't seen... And the Batrider Lasso came up, but it was just the one initiation at mid, which got... dealt with pretty well by Liquid. They kept the SF alive, so it's going to be Liquid who really make the first big move.
Looking for the chain lock, and they've...
Close.
So
he
close.
Had dust.
You did?
He had dust.
Oh.
GH?
But, Bob would have dusted. Hashtag.
Get it trending.
Oi, oi, oi. Wow. Yeah, a little bit of a... Yeah, missing out on that kill as well. Like, knocking Ace back would have been perfect. He's already not in a good position. To hold him back even more would have helped the flow for Liquid. I mean, obviously, Liquid's still in a great place because of how far Miracle and Mitsuma Man's becoming.
And, like, this Omni Knight, four Repel, four Purification. He's just on the front lines. You can't even lasso him if he's got the... Unless Repel's about to wear off, you don't lasso him because you can't do damage to him inside that Repel.
Nope.
It's a big problem. Imperial will get their first tower. It looks like at bottom. It's not really a big objective for them by any means. It's a tower that Liquid don't really care too much about. As long as they're keeping their mid-tier one alive, they've still got a lot of good map control. They've got a decent position to be able to always contest Roche with.
I just saw an Ace. This is a bit of an interesting one. What do you think about this?
They're basically saying we screwed up our early game. Okay. Let's go for the late game, I think is what it's saying. At least to me. I don't think this is an item you get if you've done... If you've achieved what you're looking to do. Yeah.
If the plan's going.
They had a lamp that wanted to be able to fight around 15 to 20 minutes. They were expecting to win that bottom lane better, but Matu just wrecked them with the Earthshaker. The Bat hasn't found all too many kills since picking up his Blink. All his kills came out of the laning stage, and Imperial's
they're not done too well. Miracle with his Invis rune. He could find something big. He's going to head towards mid lane. They've got eyes on Hestijo. Hestijo blinking away. Dying back up on GH.
Oh, Miracle has got an infested life, so he's going to walk right into them. Noya, not the best target, but Hestijo, he sure as hell is.
If he can find the setup, well, they don't even need the ult. They'll just jump out and rip him down.
I don't think OD wants to chase necessarily. I'm about to say,
nope,
that was a full stop forward from Baby Knight. Not sure about that one. And they don't actually know he used it. He could have actually gone super aggressive with that Shadowblade, because they probably don't realize he used an Invis rune. You expect the Shadowblade on cooldown, but here we go. Into Roshan. GH God is just going to chain stun Rosh as much as possible. Matu comes in. This is an easy, uncontested Roshan, I imagine. Liquid will have all the tools with an Aegis to pretty much take every tower on the map. It's not really much Imperial will have to fight into them at that stage.
Can Ace go for the big plays? Nope. Nope, he can't. He's got to leave that. Let Liquid take it. Aegis number two, my man.
Yep. And Kuro's just solo farming. Look at Kuro's at top. He's just solo farming. No allies near him. He knows if he dies here, it's like no big deal, but at the same time, like, there's bigger issues for Imperial. It's the Roche, it's everything else going on. You can also TP away from the Weaver. Oh, Weaver's on me, I guess I'll just TP out. No one to cancel is done. No big deal. Space created. And here comes Mind Control. He's possibly looking to blow up Ace. If he can find him after a Shikuchi, Shikuchi will be back up. He's going to wait for one more Shikuchi before he can go in, and that's also very dependent on Weaver using Shikuchi. So he's actually going to say screw it.
If he used it as well, he wouldn't have mana for the time lapse.
Yep. Link in.
Well, there we go. Surprise, surprise, boys and girls. Telekinesis will hold Matuma Man back. But the Astral as well. It's going to give time for Imperial to bring back up in and surround him. As you get the kill, that's the question. Jump in, a good GA from Mind Control. It's going to make it very hard to bring down Matumi. Gets the chance to rage up, back away. He survives. Miracle held back by another Astral. Baby Knight's going to move back in. They want to try and see if they can get away with a kill. And Miracle could be in trouble. They've already used all their kind of the potential to hold back and defend Matumba Man. So nothing's there to save Miracle.
Yeah, very uncoordinated fight from Liquid. Yeah. They're going to lose more.
Good patience from Imperial.
Yeah, blinking in aggressively like that on Mind Control onto an OD, that's a hero you can't kill. He's got Astral and he's got Hurricane Pike. There's zero chance of that kill.
Yeah.
It was, and the blinking is, it's a little like silly because you can't kill him, but at the same time, that's not really what costs him, because he can easily disengage. Lifestealer disengages, he doesn't even use his Aegis up. Nope. Omni Knight disengages, they're fine. They're okay, bad blink in, who cares, we're not going to die. And then Miracle goes in. After the Omni had to fully retreat, Miracle goes in, and then you're like, wait a second, what's he doing? And it's one of those things where he gets misled to fight because his teammates blink in, and it was more just like a lack of communication between Liquid, like, hey, we're not actually fighting here. But Batrider now with a full staff, and if you're Imperial, you're just looking to kind of drag this game. As much as your lineup doesn't scale better into the late game, it's really, to me, your best option right now is just to try find some pickoffs and catch. You have no farm. You have no items on your core Weaver. Your OD has some, but not enough. You need to get Baby Knight, like that second or third big item before you get really powerful, and then you try and do some plays.
A Miracle up top. They have got eyes on him. Ryze, Ace, and Noya.
I'd like to kill him.
That also, that, you know, that Mind Control is there to back him up, and it looks like Imperial realizing it's a hard one to go on.
Yeah, they see the ancient black dragon coming in with their observer, and I think realize, like, wait a second, if that dragon's coming up, the rest of Liquid are coming up. And this is more what I expect from Liquid. You have an Aegis, why not just push? Get Lifesteal in the front lines with his Aegis, have him siege, throw a repel on the SF, or even repel the Lifesteal if you really want. And just push towers. This is very straightforward for them. Imperial can't defend it. Imperial's only play is to really look for trades, and they're going to look for a trade at mid tower and bottom. They're going to find GH God. Yeah.
Ace coming in as well. They'll hold him out with one stun. GH, he actually plays way out of this. He's got 12 one charges, but with three stacks and Napalm. Yeah, he's gone.
Bit sloppy being showing down bottom. It's fine for him to be farming, but he should be farming off the map in the jungle if he's going to be farming while his team push a T2 tower. That's an impossible to defend tower. If it's a tower Imperial can defend, it's one thing, but you've got to know Imperial have zero way to defend that. They're going to be always going to be looking for trades, and the trade should be just a tower. It shouldn't be a tower under kill. So it just seems a bit uncoordinated from Liquid, but ultimately they're still in a fine position here. The lead only about 3,000 gold. My kind of impression is that it should be perhaps a bit bigger based on how good their start was. So they've kind of slipped off, giving up the SF kill, giving Imperial trades on the map, and Imperial have just done a good way to kind of claw their way back in as well. It's not all just been kind of misplays from Liquid. It's been some good decision-making from Imperial, not defending top, finding those kills, finding the tier 1 mid.
Interesting build as well from Hester Joe. Looks like it's potentially going to be the Blink 4 staff and then into the Aghanims this game.
Okay. If you look at your versing 4 melee heroes,
yep.
It just allows that initiation to be a little bit easier. I like the choice. Often an Omni will be on the front lines next to Omni's. A lot of his spells are very short cast range, so maybe you catch him with a Life Sealer and then you're looking sweet.
Yeah, but some of Magister expanding the Aegis there in the mid lane was probably coming back to the time it's going to expire.
Yeah, it's expiring in about 15 seconds from now, so just playing it safe. See what Miracle does. He's got the Helmet of Dominator, walking around with an Alpha Wolf.
And it's Deathslow down for the Timberman now as well, so...
Yeah, it's going to be the GH God Blink, which they've perhaps been missing as far as actual items on the side of Liquid.
He's very close to it. Yeah. We'll see on in the moment.
Yeah, 2150, so once he gets that, initiations become a little bit easier, as well as just team fights, because you can have the like Blink Omni Knight and start the fight, and Earthshaker comes in once Imperial look to take you on.
And there we are. So, Blink online. Would be nice if he gets that second point in the Echo Slam. He's very close to level 11. Bottom lane though, Ace starting to kick things off. Eyeing up Kuroki.
There's five heroes here. This is not a place you want to be. But
immediately backing out. Especially with your Midas off cooldown in 15 seconds.
It's looking like a manageable game for Imperial. Like, based on the early games, I'm kind of thinking in my head, like, well, this is going ugly for them. This could just be a bit of a stomp, but they've really kept it close.
Yeah,
is this an infested Rubik? Yeah, that's an infested Rubik. I was like, who's infested in bad? I'm pretty sure Machu's playing Lifestealer. Yeah. Cute little spell to steal.
And could be not. I mean, what? God, just following up the lasso with a second bit of lockdown with the jump power of telekinesis.
Yep. You can't kill the cores too easily because you need like one of your DPS heroes, your Weaver or your OD, but you can easily kill like a Earthshaker type hero with those two.
Jump in now, G8. Nice with the Rubik and bam! He's gone. So my man picks up another and now the full five man ready to push down bottom on Liquid.
Not something Imperial, I imagine, will defend. They want to go for the trades again. And they're finding the trades. Weaver did get a tier 1, so far it's been a tier 1 tower, but now the tier 2 drops, and rather than defend the tier 2 at top, Liquid actually going to force the rotation back to the Imperial high ground.
Let's see what Imperial can do about this.
Yeah, Weaver's preemptively TP'd. He realizes he needs to get Swarm out.
That's a Joe, though. Gets a good jump in onto Miracle.
Omni can't get there.
Miracle taken right back. Put the Shadow Blade, trying to get out. Sanity's his drop. He's been dusted. They can see it. Oh, they purified the wolf, did he?
Did he?
I think he purified the wolf. Unless I'm blind. I don't know if we can get a replay of that. I could be an idiot, but I think he purified the wolf.
Okay.
But
GH God in the trees. Is he going for the Blink Echo? He could do it.
Do it, GH.
He's showing on the creeps. They've got to expect it now. They see him now. And Rubik, okay, easier target. He just respawned and the same thing kills him again. Whoopsie daisy.
They're out. Well, he's out. Okay. So, Imperial, they're able to hold it. They take two kills, they lose a Rubik, but they defend the tier 3 and the Rax.
They pulled Miracle so deep into the base. Great 4-star usage. Keeping him away from the Omni. Now, Omni did have a blink, but perhaps it was like the Weaver Swarm or something just cancelling. He just couldn't quite get in there.
Did he purify the wolf? I really want to say he did. Come on, please say he did.
I didn't see any.
No, he did. He did. Oh, they purified the wolf. Miracle's probably going to have words.
Yep.
We need to talk, mind control.
Yeah, I think also there's just... Miracle should have the Omni Knight blink. Like, I guess either blink is cancelled or already used, but you've got to be trying to prevent that from happening if you're mind control, because that double 4-star play with the bat and the OD is going to always pull you in deep. And there's even a third 4-star coming. I think Abaddon recognized, like, hey, this is actually how you beat an Omni kind of Omni OD or Omni SF kind of lineup. You just pull that carry miles away from the Omni Knight. You can do that by having 3, 4, 4-stars in the Batrider. He's going to have an acceptor too soon, so Estejo may even be able to pull multiple heroes in deep.
Yeah, Imperial. Yeah, they are going to have to deal with this Butterfly Miracle next, though.
They don't have to worry about the repel. They've got the answer now with the Diffusal Blade there, and unfortunately it's an item with the Butterfly where it doesn't get dealt with well by an OD. He's just going to have to accept that a good portion of his hits are going to miss. Because you don't really build MKB on OD.
No.
That's not a thing. You could build Bloodthorn super late into the game, but again, not really he'd rather go into like a Hex plus Shivers type build, so I don't actually think we'll see a Bloodthorn unless we go like 60 minutes, so You're just going to have to accept the fact that evasion is in the mix and
try and just use your ult with the blob.
G8 just jumps in onto Ace immediately with the echo, finds a kill in response though. Has to Joe, lassos Matumba, brings him up to the base. Baby Knight jumps in with a ton of keys. They look to take now, but this time the purification's on point. Repel to follow up. Matumba man, he could turn back in. Noya pops the ultimate.
That's big when you kill that defusal carrier. The fight suddenly gets a whole lot easier when you've got that guaranteed repel.
Looks like they'll back off, Liquid.
Yep.
Happy with the pick. I mean, Roshan, I guess, is... what kind of timer are we seeing on Rosh, is it?
Almost a max respawn with a full minute before it's back.
Yep.
Good news for Imperial, who don't have Weaver for 20 seconds, that they're not going to get punished by losing an Aegis again. Miracle, yeah, he's getting pretty farmed here. May just want to tank up a little bit now, either upgrade to the Silver Edge. I don't know if you necessarily need to complete a Satanic or anything. Lincoln's is always, of course, a fantastic item to have against the Bat Initiation. And what you imagine will later on be like an OD Hex. Could buy the Shivers now. Not sure if that's what he has in mind. I think, yeah, he's got the recipe. So we'll get the Shivers and get the Hex afterwards, probably.
And there we have Aghanim's done on Bat. That's to Joe. Let's see if we can find those big double lassos. We've seen him do it before back at WSG. He won quite a game with a big fight around the Roche Pit, and that's one of the areas, you know, that this really excels. Those kind of choke points on the map where you are going to be able to get two heroes at a diamond. Well, Liquid talking about Roche, they're into it.
Yeah, that's exactly where he did it last time. But he's not... Is he going to get there in
time? That they're taking it down, they need to run. It's falling quick. No, it's too late. It's gone.
One teammate goes, but Andrew backs off.
Knight jumps in. Drops the sandwich, but the turnaround's there. There's the double lasso. He's grabbed two cores. Ace moves in. Somebody might control first. And they hold back onto Miracle, lifting him up. He turns with the right clicks. Miracle's not going to die.
They do lose mind control as well.
Hester Joe has managed to find two. He gets GH God as well.
The Weaver was, I guess, went for the other kills, but Matu had no Aegis and no HP. He's still inside the SF with no HP. He dies.
Finally goes down, though. This is a bit of a mess for Liquid, Matumba Man, and Miracle.
They're going to clean up here.
He's got another life, but what can he really do? There's five men surrounding him, and I think we might have seen it happen again. Get there, Goss. The Aghanim's on the Batrider, allowing them to lock down two cores at the start of the fight. Not necessarily killing them straight away, but getting them incredibly low.
Yeah.
And then that just spirals into a one team fight for Imperial.
Yeah, while they're lassoed, I'm like looking at they're lassoed. There's no damage. Marchu's laying on red HP, but it's because the Odium Weaver had found other targets. They deal with the Shaker. They don't let him get off an Echo Slam. They take out the Omni Knight using having the Diffusal and having the OD damage output, so they make sure this supporting cast goes out. And then they're like, okay, these carries, they're actually not as scary when you take out the repel, when you take out the bloodlust. They don't have the protection of Fissure and Echo Slam. Suddenly those carries become very easy to deal with, and Imperial are just out team fighting Liquid at this stage of the game. I mean, the Aegis, obviously you're kind of out of position when you get initiated on Roche, and that's why Imperial could take the fight into the Roche pit despite Aegis already being picked up. And Liquid have their work cut out for them now. Not sure if they can defend this tower. They do have a Blink Echo Slam. It looks like they want to go for it.
Let's see what they can find. GH to lead the way. Hester Joe keeping tabs on him though from the mid lane. And he's going to jump in. But Timberman will jump out in response. Looking to take down the bat. Hester Joe trying to get himself across the cliff. Won't make it, but they've lost GH. Now, and they get Matumba Man as well. That's the question, but the telekinesis, he's been brought down. Oh, he's out. The GA, it doesn't come quite in time. They've lost two. Ace getting the double kill. Miracle's trying to come in. We'll take down the Ruby. But Mind Control, focused down by Ace. The bugs will hit. Mind Control is out of mana and almost going to go down just to the bug.
Great Hurricane Pike.
Oi, oi, oi. Liquid beginning to crumble. They lose the courier as well on the way down. Miracle's trying to run his way out of this one. Noya will fall, but Kuroki's there to pay the price as Ace and Baby Knight clean up another. And this time Imperial, they do have casualties, but they still come out on top in terms of numbers. This is getting scary for Liquid.
Yep. OD just reaching that point where he is an absolute monster in these fights. One ultimate could finish off Miracle if he's not careful. He's trying to lifesteal some neutrals. Luckily, OD doesn't know about his whereabouts. He just piked Miracle's SF away.
Yeah.
And then just wailed away on him. Miracle just got pushed out of position, and here we go, he's gone in. Here's the ultimate. He still had 58 intel stolen. He ends with 64 after that kill. He had a huge amount of intel stolen, and SF just free food for him.
No BKB means no problem for an OD. And that's where, despite having evasion against an OD, it doesn't really care. If he steals intel from other heroes, he'll use that ultimate and take away half to two. That would have almost just killed him from full HP with the amount of int he'd stolen.
And I mean, GA's trying for a play here.
Oh no,
this is
going to backfire.
Just kind of throwing heroes into the pipeline. They do get the Weaver kill. Maybe they can turn and fight here. The lasso again, the double lasso, holding them in place is the follow-up damage there. The Tumor Man's been repelled. Stolen repel onto Hester Joe. Hester Joe running, the physical damage bringing him down. They'll wound down one, and that will allow them to take Hester Joe. Baby Knight still sticking around for the fight though. In fact, turning with the Astral, he might get Matuma Man. A couple more touches, the lifesteal looks to be too strong though. Matuma Man chasing, chomping. It doesn't matter, the right clicks do it.
That's a gem, they'll get it back. It's their own gem, but that's definitely an important item to keep their hands on.
Oh! I mean, it looked like it would be okay for Liquid jumping in, taking down Ace at the start of it. But again, Imperial come out with the trade.
Ace messed up a bit there. He sees the Earthshaker and has to assume there's a lifesteal inside. He shouldn't be dying to that combo. But ultimately, Earthshaker did solo echo him just to make sure that he could chain stun him and get the kill. But Ace needs to stay alive. He's the defusal carry. If he dies, he's dying first in a lot of these fights, and losing that defusal definitely hurts Imperial. But ultimately, they're kiting so well using these four staffs, using the telekinesis, the Batrider lasso, all their tools that they have just so effectively that they're winning the fights, even without that Weaver, even when they're fighting into the repel.
It's...
Oh god, 5.5k on Baby Knight. Oh, hello.
What's going to pick up, do you think?
Should be a Hex, but it's Hex, I imagine. I mentioned the Bloodstone earlier.
Does he need a BKB this game, or...?
Eventually, I guess you may as well buy one against an Earthshaker so you can just blink in with BKB and kill everyone, but I want to say the Hex, just so you can kill a... Punish the SF for not having a BKB just through your ultimate. With a Hex,
absolutely.
You destroy that SF with your Sanity.
Or do you just go YOLO MKB build?
No. Get the Bloodthorn. If you're going to do that, go Bloodthorn. He says he's OD.
He's going Octarine.
Baby Knight's done. This is the Baby Knight build. He actually loves his Octarine core. I don't know what it does for an OD. I can't say I build this item on my own OD, but Baby Knight, he knows a lot better than I do, so.
I mean, I think, obviously, the kind of the cooldown's nice, but I think, I guess, the lifesteal with the Arcane Orb.
Yep.
The lifesteal's great.
And it's the way the Arcane Orb is, it's a percent of your mana pool goes to damage. So, this item is one of the best items for boosting up your mana pool. It's 25 int and 425 mana. It gives you
a bazillion mana.
I don't know how much, but it's like 1,000 or something. Round up to maybe 2,000. And you're pretty good. And you lifesteal. Like, it's the OD equivalent of lifesteal with the Arcane Orb, I assume, giving you lifesteal with Octarine Core. I don't really know how this item works in OD.
But in theory, you should lifesteal on the arcane damage. Yeah,
arcane damage, you lifesteal. Sanity's Eclipse should get you like full HP if you hit like five heroes with it. It should do some crazy stuff on OD. Like if you theory craft the item on OD, you're like, wait a second, this item's amazing.
Especially when you can get it at this kind of time. You know, you're up there, you're having a great game. And well, let's see what we have coming out on top. Liquid making their way across the map, bringing the full five team up towards the top lane. It's just going to be interesting if they do try and go for some sort of siege, because it's hard to do against Imperial's lineup with the jump in, the catch potential of the Rubick, the OD, the Power Rider with the Aghanims. It is scary for Liquid.
We still pick up a Mjolnir now. That's an interesting little pickup. Some good damage output. I mean, you get the procs on both your attacks with the Geminite potentially. Yep. And just something that he can put on himself for. If he's getting stunned a lot, he can still dish out some damage using those Mjolnir procs. He can put on a teammate as well. Like if someone like Odie's or Bat wants to go in, you put the Mjolnir on them rather than yourself as well, since they'll be the one getting focused on. Kind of reaching that point where I just feel like SF does just need to say, look, okay, I'm going to go back and get a BKB because Repel's not reliable. Oh, yeah, sorry, I say that he has. What am I talking about? Miracle did go back for the BKB, and this is very much a necessary item given how these fights are going down and the repel just not always being, it's not always there and it's just not reliable with against a defusal.
Now towards the mid lane, Imperial smoked up, ready to see if they can find that jump. All eyes on Hester Joe really to see if he can get the two-man lasso off again. But Liquid, they're playing it careful. They know that something fishy's going on with no heroes revealing themselves across the map. They keep themselves up and safe on the high ground of their base.
Yeah, no buyback on a lot of these Radiant heroes, both their carries actually. Neither Lifesteal nor SF is buyback. They lose this fight, it could just be game over. And Baby Knight's invis. He's running into a sentry though.
They will have the chance to to read the situation here. Just to be a quick Astral, looking to come back in with the Shiva's Garb, a miracle. Hurricane pikes himself back up to the high ground. He'll be fine for now.
Yeah, Radiant Vision now, at least maintained for now at this point, but it will get immediately dealt with.
Miracle looking to frontline this fight with the BKB just going ham onto Baby Knight. They come in with the Echo Sound, the Chain Stuns, it's beautiful, it's enough. And with the Requiem as well. Imperial, they've got to be careful there, an OD down. A huge amount of their damage lost, and Miracle rips apart the Abaddon.
Oh, he tried to full stuff in to save the OD there, but got stunned himself and didn't proc his ultimate in time to actually heal up the OD. And OD just, yeah, he died fast. He kind of asked earlier, does he need a BKB? And you see situations like that, and you're like, yeah, probably does. That was with the Octarine boosting up not just his mana pool, but his hit points as well. Great fight for Illiquid, and, well, I mentioned Illiquid's core not having buyback. It's also Imperial.
Yep, no buyback,
no buyback on OD. None on Abaddon. Bat doesn't have one. Weaver does.
Miracle can push Taz like an absolute beast with the Butterfly. You can see the damage he's doing at this stage again. Nearly 400 straight up. And look at the attack speed as well.
Yeah, he's still even got the Alpha Wolf just to help him push out.
Jump in. Look for the lasso. I grab him back. He's been repelled. Good stun from GH holding the bat. Miracle. And that's going to be defusaled. He's back himself out now, focusing on the tag again. But Timberman looking to go in deep, focusing the squishies first, takes down Rubik. And they've got to pop the fortification here. The base under threat for the side of Imperial. Miracle just standing his ground, takes down the bugs. Good stun onto Ace again, holding him back, making it very hard for Imperial to defend. They'll lose the melee racks. And Miracle, can he get himself out of this? They've got the backup as Baby Knight respawns. But they've lost the melee racks, and as we're seeing at this stage of the game, one bad fight. I mean, even just losing two heroes, and suddenly structural damage will be done.
Yeah. I think the best thing we're seeing from Liquid when it comes to their team fight is just really nicely timed fissures. Like, when the lasso comes out in SF, Urshank is there with the fissure just to stop Batrider pulling him too deep in the Imperial base. If he gets pulled to the tier 4, suddenly Liquid's forced into perhaps an unfavorable fight. Same thing around the fight that where they initially killed the OD. He hit the fissure not just on the OD, but also on the Abaddon coming in. There's been a couple really good multiple hero fissures out of GH Garden. He's continued to be that playmaker. He's shadowblading around trying to find kills, and he may actually find Ace again. Has no blink for a couple of seconds. Does look like Ace gets out just in time. If he was there a second earlier, that was a kill.
Time. Roshan's back up. It'll be interesting to see if either team gets the chance to head in and take it. Both with pretty good potential of bringing it down fast.
Yeah, Batrider is the really scary hero to fight around the pit because of that Acceptor. Having two heroes in the pit, I mean, having more than one hero in the pit, they're always going to get multiple
lassos off. I think Imperial could take this before they could have a chance of getting in the neighborhood.
Definitely possible. They've got decent physical damage at this point, and even I guess just a single point curse to the Arvanist, but at least it's something. You get that attack speed bonus.
No vision around the pit at all for Liquid, so Imperial get away with this one for free. Aegis onto Baby Knight, and I believe Ace picked up the cheese.
That's a nice tool to have as they take their next couple of fights. It's a smoked up Liquid who were perhaps not expecting that Rosh to drop when it did, because they don't necessarily want to fight into the Aegis and cheese, but element of surprise could play in their favor.
They could still try and fight. Miracle's just picked up a Daedalus. Huge amounts of damage coming out from him. GH will jump in. They look to focus Baby Knight first, but he's forced back, kept alive, and now with the Shiva's Guard ready to go back in. Sanity's Eclipse, so huge damage. White's GH got the Miracle, wants the BKB, rips the piece of the Rubik, turns towards Noia. Noia's got the ult. To Liquid has Miracle focusing towards Baby Knight, looking for the Requiem to get the damage reduction down. Slowing Imperial up, forcing them to back. They've lost two on both sides at the moment. Nice blink away from Baby Knight just in time, and again holds Miracle back with the Astral. Baby Knight will get himself out of there, but a quick fight as both teams, well, Liquid losing the two supports, Imperial do lose Hestijar on the bat, so I think Liquid will be fine with that, especially considering that was a fight into a team that's holding an Aegis and a cheese.
Yep, find way to, they also didn't get off the best initiation going on Baby Knight when the Abaddon this time was in a good position to instantly get the shield on, take off those stuns. He has an Aether Lens now, which really helps Noia out when it comes to fights like that, but ultimately, it was an alright exchange for Liquid. Miracle's Daedalus giving him a huge amount of single target damage now. If you get up to like a Satanic, he's going to become a big problem for Imperial to deal with. I think this is where Ace has to start considering getting an MKB.
And he's certainly got the money to start thinking about it.
Yeah. He can place his probably just TP scrolls, I'm not sure. He's going to hold into the cheese for now. Maybe
Is he getting to the point where he could just sell the miners?
Yeah, you definitely can. Yeah. It's attack speed, though, I guess that's where it's like, it's always like, it hurts you. It's like, would you rather keep your Midas or your TP scrolls? may want to get a butterfly of his own as well, since the SF and Lifestealer don't have MKB, something you can try and punish. Maybe Knight, not going to find GH up top.
Yeah, they're out with the TPs. Yeah. They do scan the area as well just to see if he was hanging around. But
playing into the BKBs now is like, Baby Knight, you want to have a Hex just so SF's ever alone. You want to be out, and same with Lifestealer, you want to be able to get the Blink Hex off and prevent them from using their magic immunity. Hard to do it on the Lifestealer because he's almost always infested in one of his cores. Matthew's at that point where he has enough items for fighting that he doesn't want to ever be out of infest because he can get initiated. A Blink Lasso or an instant telekinesis, there's all these instant disables that can prevent him from raging, so coming out of infest is his best bet.
Liquid just storming down the mid lane.
They ain't scared of no cheese or Aegis. This is twice in a row now they're smoking up, trying to fight into the Aegis cheese.
Looking for the high ground advantage, hoping that Imperial head out, and then Deep Baby Knight starting to push the wave outside of the base. They've got the team followed behind them, but Baby Knight actually wants to make the jump up to the high ground with the Shiva's guard, immediately forces back down. GH God, he sinks himself away.
Scouts with that Blink Shiva's.
Baby Knight, he's come back in again, astrally up the Earthshaker. Huge amount of damage there, miracle to pop the BKB. Look at Baby Knight. Baby Knight still alive though. GA comes out from mind control. Baby Knight with the sanity, he's bursting down one. Miracle still continues to try and fight, but they've already lost two on the team. GH God with the slam, the stun. They've controlled Ace. They've taken down the Weaver. It's a 2-for-2 at the moment. Baby Knight, can he find anything more? Forces forward, jumps in with the Blink, looking for Miracle, but the evasion on the SF, keeping him alive. No, it's not enough. Baby Knight still able to bring Miracle down. He doesn't quite have enough evasion to dodge out the damage of this beast, as Liquid will lose the battle.
It's Baby Knight chasing. This is risky.
He wants to go.
Oh, it's got a haste now even. But it's an 4-star Blink, Shatterblade. GH God has all the mobility. He's the one who's going to turn around, and I think with good reason.
But I like it.
Abaddon, he's got 8 seconds without the ultimate, but doesn't look like he'll find that kill, and GH God will just look back towards his bottom lane. Very even game one here. No one really pulling away. It's dead even, of course. This is the kind of Dota we're hoping for between these
really
two teams.
Good.
And
really good stuff. And it's top performance for both teams. It's not really mistakes being made. Yep. It's just both teams reacting very nicely to how each other's jumping in on them. We saw like that, you know, Baby Knight tries to get in, and it pays off, but only just. It's close fights.
He's just going balls to the wall in the front lines there. He's got another 6.5k. Curious to see what he replaces Aegis with. We mentioned the BKB at some point, but I think a Hex is just so good.
Oh, Croaky. He'll be fine. Baby Knight, of course, himself not carrying any vision. Even with that, I mean, Hurricane piking someone away, you're never going to be able to get the kill.
Battle. Make sure he gets the D wards going. He had to pick up another gem. Looks like Noya bought it for the team. So the gem control, of course, one of those key things later on in the game. Losing the first gem means they have to buy the second, and Liquid themselves, I believe, haven't had to buy a gem this game.
A bit of a late mech, but it's a little something that they can add to the fight there, picked up by Ryze.
Yeah, he always goes for this. It's like his classic build. I've never seen him really deviate from this build. It seems weird when you see that 45-minute mech. Like, is a mech really going to do much at 45 minutes? But getting the buckler, like, it's just such like a kind of value item earlier on in the game, and then you're like, well, I may as well upgrade to a mech. It's hard to say. Like, there's some situations where having a 4-star would just be better, but there's already 3 on your team, and you're not really. I don't know. It's really just hard to say which can have a higher impact. Someone like Hesterjo with a lasso can get the pull even further if you get like the extra 4-star on him. But
and it is quite a fascinating build from Ace this game on the Weaver. You know, there's kind of a Lincoln to an AC, Mjolnir. It's something a little bit different.
Yep. A bit of everything. The AC I really like against the minus armor, the SF, and the physical damage coming out from him and Lifestealer. But it helps out the team as well. Like, the selfish approach is you go the butterfly because they don't have MKBs. It gives you agi, which gives you armor as well as the evasion to help sustain you against physical damage. But he says, look, it's not all about me. I'm going to be a team player. I'm going to get this AC to help out my Batrider as well as my OD. And we'll go from there. I actually want to say Baby Knight might go Refresher here. That could be the item which could really turn this game. Having double ult. It's his ultimate that is getting the kills. He used the ultimate at the start. They win the last fight because his ultimate insta-kills the Omni Knight. Helped kill like a couple of heroes, really, and with two ultimates, he may just be the king of team fight.
Miracle
he's saving a lot of money.
What was Miracle? Is that? That's not a full set. It was on the courier for Miracle. Was he just sent out to like a secret shop?
Is it Satanic?
Yeah, it is. Satanic. Yeah, so the full out Satanic done.
for Miracle.
But, yeah, OD's still saving money for now. He's got money for Refresher and Buyback.
At the moment, just, yeah, heading back to base. No movement of their own courier, so no indication of whether Baby Knight is going to make that purchase. Unless it is indeed the Refresher's orb straight from the fountain.
He's got 6.5k surplus. Yep. He can buy anything he wants and still have Buyback. The only thing you can't buy with Buyback is like a Dagon 5, which is also not a terrible hunter choice. Like, Dagon 5, why not? It's single target burst damage. It's really what he wants. But ultimately, Refresher is better than Dagon, so I don't see him buying that. And...
Oh, he's going to go for the Blood Form.
Actually, yeah, we mentioned this ages ago. It's like, oh, he's only going to get this if the game goes 60 minutes. Well, it's not quite there. 60 minutes, but yeah, we are getting there.
Yeah.
And this is the item to help against the SF Butterfly. Problem is he's got BKB to maybe get rid of it. He can get repelled, but it's still very useful if you can catch him outside of that BKB, which is down to just 7 seconds now. No, and again, it's not just for the SF. It could also help against the Lifesteal. Lifesteal actually does have no way of getting out of that himself, so could really try and punish Matu with the silence.
Yeah, I guess you've got to really look to the repels from Mind Control being really clutch. Yeah.
Absolutely. Mind Control himself has grief, so he can get rid of the silence. Shaker doesn't have a good way out. Oh, Shaker, speaking of which, he's been caught.
And this time he doesn't have Matuma Man inside him. This is GH all on his own. And he will force down. And with the Shadow Blade, Hester Joe obviously with the gem. They'll chase it down, blinking a Baby Knight, taking out the Shaker. GH does have Buyback if it comes to it, but he's down for 60 seconds, so we could potentially see a bit of a stale point of the game where both teams just wait it out, unless Imperial feel that they can force something with the Shaker off the map.
No, but at this pace, it's
unlikely.
Yeah, they'll likely just fall back, push out their lanes, look for another lasso kill. Kind of reaching that point where people will be buying lots of Boots of Travels to try and push out the lanes, use that mobility to find some pickoffs. Waiting out next Roche's as well. I guess less room on some of these cores for items like Aegis. Someone like Baby Knight doesn't actually have space unless he drops his Blink Dagger. And we'll see. I mean, everyone's kind of getting to that point where they're getting close to six slotted. Lifesteal has a bit of room to grow with the Abyssal still not there, as well as an Echo Saber to upgrade. But ultimately, Lifesteal against all these four staffs and against the Weaver is going to struggle to dish out damage on heroes that aren't being controlled by the stuns. He needs to always be investing in the Earthshaker because he doesn't get kills without the Earthshaker stun. So he's got to just hope that the Shaker can get these good initiations, which for the most part, GH God has found at various stages of this game.
And it's going to be the selling of the Midas for Ace picks up a Reaver.
Oh,
so the Reaver Weaver.
His interesting build to continue. I mean, again, not going MKB against SF. Not something I would have expected, but he's tanking up.
I mean, that's the thing, you know, with an AC, with an inevitable heart, and the Mjolnir Lightning Shield, he's quite the little bugger to take down, quite literally.
I wonder if he even goes Satanic. I think Satanic is almost somewhere, who knows, really. This is not your everyday cookie cutter Weaver build.
It really is.
If these players were going for the standard cookie cutter builds that you see most games, it'd be very easy to say and explain what they're doing, but these, between the OD and the Weaver, they're doing something different, but that's always been the Imperial way.
Aegis and Cheese again.
Heart just films, like, all Heart does is give you HP. Like, that's all it does is raw HP, whereas Satanic, it gives you a bit less HP and doesn't give you the HP I mean, the Satanic effect is very similar to the Heart regen effect.
What's he got on it? He's gonna go for the Heart.
Yeah, it's a Heart. It's just raw HP. That's what this gives you. Means he's not going to get blown up by the Earthshaker chain stun as much. And then he can just back off and heal up. It's a very similar item to say Satanic in the way it works, that you just have raw HP, you survive, and then you heal. Satanic is more you can heal while fighting, whereas Heart you have to disengage, then you heal, then you re-engage. And this was like your classic old-school Weaver build where you just go like Lincoln's Deso Heart, and then you're tanky, you do damage, and you can block the stuns.
Smoke, you know. Noida is going to be spotted. Not really the ideal target to jump.
Yeah.
Baby Knight, though, a little bit more appealing, but immediately just blinking off. Imperial moving their way around the map.
The ward will be awarded, so Imperial will be aware that Liquid, they've got something going on around it. Ace actually going to lead for it, though. GH moving in with a power, jumps into the Echo Snap, follows through with some of that, jumping out, they've taken out the Batrider. Miracle focusing Baby Knight, forcing him back. The Guardian Angel comes out from Mind Control. Ace being locked up in the midst of it all. Open Woods is there, but Ace has been able to find the Ogre Kill. Time Lapse is back, they picked up a second. They'll look now towards Mind Control, he's dragged back into the midst of it all. It's going to be the Omni Knight going down as well, as Imperial find three. And Liquid, the team with the jump in, and it just does not work out.
Just needed a bat buyback, and yeah. Bat buys back, TP's in, doesn't even really become needed for the fight. They win it without him, and he's now got Lasso for this push. They want to press forward.
It's a good push as well. Yeah. Well, you got no Omni Knight for 50 seconds. Even if he was back up, GA's not going to be there. Echo Slam's now on cooldown.
Yeah, they got an Aegis on Ace as well, so he can just kind of frontline here with the Heart. He is an absolute beast. Shaken will buy back, but you know he's got no Echo Slam, so you probably feel confident you can just continue pushing, even as a grouped up unit.
And look at his
too big a threat.
He is ready to react with a Blink Force and a Lasso for anyone dares come forward.
We can't go near this, it feels. This is likely just going to be an uncontested Rax. Does even things up. Liquid took a Rax himself. They just want to wait for the Omni Ogre to respawn. Just having Bloodlust makes a big difference, but Repel, of course, very useful. So there's no point fighting over one lane of Rax when you're this far into a game. And I'll let the melee Rax go and probably try and fight should Imperial go for a second lane.
Imperial to be very happy with that series of events. Opening up the game even more for them now. Two buybacks on cooldown, for one for each respective side. That's something to bear in mind. And it looks like, be interested to see how hard Imperial wants to go in again.
Just feels like Imperial are just scaling into the late game better with the OD. He's not even going to a Hex. He can buy a Refresher now and just have it on the Courier around him. Being able to team fight with your ultimate and then just back off, refresh, have another ultimate 20 seconds later, like for the Liquid potential buybacks, because they're gonna have buybacks for the high ground defense, means you're just that much harder to beat. So,
oh,
I guess it felt desperate for Liquid.
What did he sell? Did he have?
He's got boots.
Rip boots. I mean, a rapier over boots any days. That's how they do it in 9K. I like it. Rapier Shadow Fiend, ladies and gentlemen.
Sure.
Oh, yeah. We're seeing as well, I believe Matuma Man pretty much has, yeah, he's got it. It was on the curve.
He
full
actually,
out of pistol.
Oh, he's still got buyback too, so he likely will lead the fight.
Miracle does not have buyback, but of course you get Rapier, it doesn't matter. You're going all in at this point.
Oh, and they're smoking it from the side. This is a ballsy play.
Get ready for the deeps of the SF.
He needs that Bloodlust. Come on, Kuro. Hook him up.
GH has the Echo Slam as well. Just Ace is like, ow, that hurts.
Yeah, there's no point hiding a Rapier. At some point, you're like, well, I'm an SF. I got to push these lanes out. Yep. It's not my job to stay hidden. I'm no Earthshaker. So Imperial will be well aware of this and kind of see that, okay, this is kind of all in play. Let's not rush things here. Yeah, we've got the Aegis. We can siege this, but we don't want to get caught out in a bad position. And that's what he has to do. He's positioned on the cliff. He wants to make sure he doesn't get caught by surprise.
Wow, Ace. Time that's him back. Miracle. Just man-moding at the front on this defense. Hester Joe will, of course, be keeping eyes out for a potential lasso initiation. But Imperial looks to be a little scared about this. They'll head back. They'll leave this for another day.
You know, you see that Rapier thinking, yeah, like, uh-oh, what's going on? And also, you don't have buyback on bat.
No.
You also lose... I think the Aegis is being lost. Yeah, Aegis is down.
Pretty much gone.
Second.
Bang on.
So, no more Aegis.
Long
Weavers.
Respawn as well, I believe, isn't it? 5 minutes.
Yeah, that's on the longer side. So, Weaver's got an item slot you could perhaps look to fill, or just wait for that next Aegis. I think you see this SF Rapier and think, let's not rush and make any rash decisions and fight into it. With the rape you pick up, it's kind of like playing without buyback, even when you have buyback, because you lose the rape, you give it to the other team. So it's a very risky state to be in for Liquid. And that's where I think Imperial looking like this. Okay, then we don't have to worry too much. Let's make sure we all have buybacks, because it's the bat. He's the one hero without with buyback on cooldown on the Imperial side, Earthshaker on the Radiant side, but Batrider a bit more of a key hero at this stage and looking to finish a BKB. He's actually, yeah, there we go, he's got it now.
I mean, I think the great thing about this game as well is I don't know if necessarily, if Miracle does go down, loses the Rapier, is that necessarily game over? Or?
It's
close to game over,
yeah.
I want to say.
Is it pretty bad?
It's pretty bad. What's OD done? He's bought a Moonshard, didn't actually... So no refresher just yet. Moonshard plus Boots of Travel. We can get the Travels to this game as well, of course. Like, you're looking for these pickoffs. You want to be able to TP on heroes, not just creeps.
Yeah, getting
when
on
you
the
buy
Weaver
back.
Or the Bat. Yeah.
Yeah, Weaver can Bat can initiate, have someone TP on top of him.
Yeah.
And they're looking for that play. They're probably saying, if you get a lasso on someone like Miracle, four-staff him the hell away from his team. Use 2, 3, 4 four-staffs if we have to. You can ask. He's got no buyback for now. I'm curious to see if he can get farm that before a fight comes.
Okay, Hester Joe.
Blind blink.
Yeah, it's Baby Knight just getting vision with the Shiva's guard.
Imperial
it's
makes some
risky.
Yeah, they like to make these gutsy calls where they're just like, let's go for it. Let's see what we find. They know that somewhere in the neighborhood, they were just slightly off when they guessed where they were as far as the blink in.
I think at this point as well, I'm looking at Neuer. He's when I last checked, he was coming out to about 3k gold. I feel this would be kind of a nice game if he gets the Aghanim Scepter and has the damage redirect because
that's
of the damage
huge.
That Liquid are doing.
For sure. Yeah. That's a big item to pick up in late game
play. I mean, I don't know what else necessarily could be thinking about, because it's already an AC. They've got auras.
Have they got the Vlads?
They don't have a Vlads.
I mean, Vlads is really like one of the most value cost-effective items in late game, but with that said, the Axe is, I mean, you're potentially redirecting 50% of incoming damage. It's only 900 radius is decent. It's not like incredible, but it's definitely decent. The Vlads is, I don't know, I guess the more stable item pickup, but I'd like to see the Axe. The Axe sounds absolutely fantastic. There's no real other items he needs. If anything, it could be a better item pickup than having like the Aether Lens, but he can just fall back, try and farm it. Kind of hard to farm as an Abaddon because you don't push lanes fast enough. You're not really being allocated farm. It's where you wish, like, man, I wish I had a Midas or something.
What's that on the curve for the Weaver? I imagine it's an MKB. It's not the Dream. It's not
it
another
is MKB.
It is the MKB. Yep. So. What did he get rid for that one?
He had the opener, empty item. So he has no boots.
He had the Aegis, the cheese, yeah.
Yeah, okay. He had Aegis, he had cheese, and then he just had an empty item slot, so he filled it with the MKB. And now he just needs a couple hundred for buyback, so he's actually not going to go fight till he has that. Needs to be a little bit careful.
I mean, this is the thing. Obviously, with this Rapier purchase, Liquid being very cautious about leaving the base. Now they'll start to move out, but for the most part, they have literally been sitting on that high ground.
They can't really easily push out. That's definitely true. So, see how they play. I don't really see that, like, with a Rapier. It's not like an item where you're like, okay, let's go fight. It's an item where it's like, okay, I hope they come and fight us.
Okay, come and fight me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm ready for you, but Imperial just, like, chilling their side of the map. Getting their ultra late game luxury items, probably grabbing themselves another Aegis if they really want, you know. Get someone like a... I guess Batrite doesn't have room for the Aegis. He really needs that gem. Like, dropping a gem doesn't seem... I guess Abaddon has one, but it's just so good on Batrite when he's in the front.
And at this point, buyback-wise, they're all coming back. You're just seeing a couple of support... Well, Mind Control and Rubik for respective sides without it. And Bat maybe the bigger deal. Hester Joe's still short on the gold. For buyback at this stage, but at this stage, you know, at this point in the game, if you're finding the fights, as long as he gets kind of involved in one or two kills before he dies, he's probably going to have the bounty to get back in.
Interesting. Liquid smoke in a very curious place and direction. Okay, that's why they smoke up there. So wait, what did he drop this time? He dropped
I know. Wempis is going to desperately try and tell us.
Swedish keyboards.
Pike. Thanks, man. Oh, dude. Okay, so, yeah, who needs a hurricane pike? When you can shove something a bit harder. Couple of second wave. We found Ace. He jumps in, he gets the stun. Head to go, can he get the lasso off? Matuma Man playing around it. Miracle looking at Baby Knight. Baby Knight just getting ripped to shreds by the double rapier.
Oh, he's shot it
out. Take it down as well. Oh, my goodness. These rapiers certainly do what they say on the tin. The damage is unreal from Miracle. They just ripped two heroes off the map from Imperial, and Roshan's alive.
I mean, you know if Miracle can take the Aegis.
Does he just give someone the BKB to hold, pick up the Aegis?
That's a decent idea. But that's awesome.
Matu's
fine. Like, this is, I think Miracle's not really easy. Again, if you're Imperial, you're like, high ground defense, lasso Miracle, and pull him deep into your base. Everyone, chuck a four-star. They've got only...
Get in the fountain.
They've still got the 3 four-stars, but that's... Actually, they only have two with Abaddon not having buyback. But they need to pull him far, far away from absolutely everyone. Oh, yeah.
And Abaddon, the Dream of the Axe is gone. He's come for the Ghost Scepter, which you kind of need when this man's killing you. But here we have the Lasso onto Miracle. Look at the damage from Ace. Miracle's falling low. Miracle, he's probably going to go down. Oh, this next he heals up. It's not enough. Oh. Miracle's down. The Rapier's hit the deck. Oi, 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 Baby Knight, they're in trouble. The Tumor Man's focusing. Ding, ding, ding is a good multicast from Kuroki. Baby Knight kept alive, though, with the Astral. The Tumor Man invests just back out, but he's lost the Aegis. Silence summons Kuroki, they've lost Kuro as well. Oh, Baby Knight, he's so low, but they can't finish him off. The Astral's himself, the Tumor Man looking to be invited to Ace, but he just hasn't got the damage. He'll turn towards Heshika, but the Stolen Fish is there. Imperial take him down as well.
Well, SF is buyback.
So, but he doesn't have no rapiers.
Yeah, he's got no
boots. He ain't got no rapiers.
Who's taking it? Ryze took one.
Oh, Rubik Rapier. It's like, this man, he doesn't steal spells. He steals your weapons too.
It's like, who does take it though? I guess Ace would have to drop like a Lincoln's or something. I mean, drop your Mjolnir. Let's be real here. Drop a Mjolnir, pick a rapier up. But now he says, let's not do that crap.
Oh, GH. You don't want to stand there. Get yourself back.
Those rapiers are still sitting there.
They don't need rapiers.
No, they don't. If SF gets to him, though, then you're kind of question-marking yourselves, but he's got no TPs, he's got no travels.
I mean, it's not over. That's what,
no,
they've lost two rapiers,
over.
But
it's...
they're not tapping out, because Liquid still have another chance to fight this.
No.
They're going to lose bottom rats.
Yeah, buyback for Lifestealer, yeah. They've got to just wait 20 seconds now to have all five alive.
20 seconds of pain.
Yeah, what's SF going to buy? Buy some treads or something here? I don't know. What do you buy with 2k gold and 2 empty item slots?
Get yourself a Ghost Scepter. I don't know, I guess.
I don't know. Phase boots.
I mean, some kind of boots.
I hope so.
Tranquil. Let's go.
No, he's just butterflying forward.
He's saving up for the next rapier.
He bought TP scrolls, but no boots.
Wow.
Okay.
TP gets you to a tier 3 faster than walking to it from the fountain. I love it.
He's got bloodlust. Like, bloodlust butterflies some more at movement speed. You flutter around. It also actually wants to save his buyback.
Oh no! Miracle! Lassoed up! Mind Control jumping in with the repel! He always wants to say Tanic, it's not enough! Miracle's down! Oh no!
GH got in no man's land. Where is the Shaker? He was like over near Roshan. He's gone on a walkabout.
He's trying to find Bulba and get him back in the team. Oh. He's like, take my place. I don't know what's happening. It's crazy. I'm losing my mind, GH.
Whoa.
Oh, Echo Slam, Matuma Man looking towards... Oh, that's the rapier. That's the rapier on the deck, boys. Pick it up, Matuma Man.
Yeah,
he's got the rapier. Looks towards Baby Knight. Can they do it here? Sanity's just dropped over. Matuma Man falling low. Gets the Abyssal out. Chop, chop, chop. It's not enough. Oh, it's too late. Oh, Liquid have fallen. Imperial have done it. What a game.
Whew.
What a performance.
Don't know what happened this game. That was weird.
Liquid
fun.
Versus Imperial, arguably one of the most entertaining games we've had so far in the Dream. Rapiers, everything's...